What's up, guys? Mahiwagang gabi. Hopefully okay lang yung audio. I think ang pinakapangit ito sa ano sa live stream style is hindi maganda yung ano, yung pick up ng microphone. Siguro kailangan ko ayusin sa hangouts kasi maganda yung ano. Maganda yung tunog ng microphone. Sa Google Hangouts, malamang marami ginagawa si Google para ma-edit si si ano. May ginagawa si Hangouts para maganda yung microphone. Dito kasi medyo ano, medyo robotic yung tunog ng microphone. Masama ba kung ano? Asap. Kapulitan nyo. Let's try this. That's working. Let's try that. Yan. Asap. Asap na. Pray for Paris, yes. Masama ba kung ano? Yan. Ito. Pray for Paris. Mali nagawa ko. Yan. Kapa. Kailangan natin. Mumurahin tayo ng mga ano yun, ang tao kung hindi kapa. Kapa. Oh boy. Ah, may haters na tayo, sigurado lang. That's a lot of pictures. Maraming pictures si Paris Hilton. Alright, close. I guess we could start. Hindi pa ako sanay. Okay, kailangan ko mag-post ng links sa mga dudes. Dude bros. Okay. Link is here. We're starting now. Copy. We're starting now. Starting now. Link is here. Nope. That's not it. Hindi natin ang konti. Baka mamaya maputol, yun. Yan ang ano eh, yung pag naputol, ibig sabihin BTS yung pinapanood nyo. Kasi BTS always has problems. Hindi pwedeng walang problema ang BTS. Surprisingly, umaandar ang aking ano. Guys, kamusta yung stream? Is it laggy, walang lag, pangit? Walang tripod. Ano pa pwede nyo sabihin? Okay, meron na doon. Kitang-kita nyo yung mga tao sa aking Facebook feed. Alright, maanda lang ating ano. Yung BTS dati na may secret episode. Oo nga pala. Oh, sino nagpasok? Ay, hindi. Ito, that's last week. This, oh my God. Oh, starting now. Link is here. And then, Shukura Shiniba, what's up? Welcome back. Brethren Pablo, welcome back. I'm gonna post the, ito hindi nyo makikita kasi nasa kabilang, ando sa kabilang monitor. I'm gonna post the link sa ating Twitter accounts. BTS is live. We're talking about a Cherry Mobile PH prepaid Happy Man Star Mobile Night Spectra and Lenovo Mobile Philippines Vibe P1 Mini. Hindi ko alam kung P1 Mini yung tawag nila kasi P1M. Pero ina-assume ko yung P1M means P1 Mini, di ba? Ako kung hindi naman pasok yung link. Okay. Topics. Topics. Spectra. Pagalin natin yung more para magkasya. Okay. Yeah. Space. Okay, kasha na sa tweet. Alright, tweeting. All right, nag-spam na tayo sa Twitter. Yay! Walang lag sa stream, kuya. Pati mo. But di mo type sa comment box. Kappa. Since ano, since live comments tayo, Kappa. Kappa. Everybody Kappa. Hashtag Kappa. Kung hindi nyo alam yung Kappa, it's a Twitch, no? Twitch emoticon. Meaning sarcastic. Sarcastic joke. Ay, pagloko ka. Wala kaya. Ano? Ha? Huh? Anong wala? Anong wala? Nasa right side ng player yung comments, live comments. Oh, wait. Wala ba tayong live comment? Inuloko niyo ako, ipipindutin. Mapanood, ito tanin ko ah. Ah, okay. So, ito yung live comments guys, oh. Live comment. Tindi-tindi ng setup natin eh. Ang ganda nung ano ko eh. Ang ganda nung setup ko eh. Pinahi. Niloloko nyo pa ako eh. Pinakahirap ko na nga eh. You're joking me. Nagla-lag yung PC. Sorry. PC lagging. Sorry. Sino dito? Si... Search mo sa Google lang SKK Link Locks. Napag-usapan na yun last week. A few weeks ago si Link Locks. I mean, ang problema sa Link Locks, wala naman tayong unit eh. Ayoko na magkwento. Magkakwentohan ba tayo tungkol sa SKK na naman, guys? Magkakwentohan naman tayo. Di lang siya nakasign in. Okay. iPad, anong iPad Air? You mean iPad Pro? Air Ocampo. So guys, kung nakikita nyo sa ating live stream, ha, automatic yung comments nyo, nasa live stream na, high tech! Ang hirap lang i-setup to. Mahirap i-setup. Yung Spectra parang may cyanogen mode. Actually, sa iPad Pro. Yeah, iPad Pro. Pare, may joke ako sa iPad Pro eh. iPad Pro? More like iPad No! Wala lang. Corny. Wala lang ka-cowboys. Gusto nyo isama yung ka-cowboys. Kaya lang nag-logout ako kasi yung sakit ng ano eh. Kaka-logout ko lang. Gusto nyo isama ko si ka-cowboys. Isama natin si ka-cowboys. Thanks. Pinahihirapan nyo lang ako eh. Hanggang ano oras ng stream, most likely mga 11:30 to 12. Hanggang gano'n. Gusto nyo bang isama si Kakao? Wala naman kanina nag-chat ako sa Kakao Boys. Wala nagsasalita sa Kakao Boys. Tagalin natin si browser. Makita nyo yung ating... Ito na lang si Kakao Boys. Nandito sa ano. And it's Lenovo. Thumb! Baliktad yung thumb. Dito sa thumb. Oh, nakuha pa rin. Asan si Kakao? Ayan, Kakao Boys. Yeah, sponsored. But wala akong comments, mga Kap? Anong Kap? Meron kuya. Noob. Daw kayo sabi ni Cham. Yeah. Ayan, Kakao Boys, shout out. Kung gusto nyo sumali sa Kakao Chat, 24 oras po yan, nakipagdaldalan tayo. I-exit ko na lang si Kakao kasi medyo masakit sa ano. Magkailangan ko ng memory dahil sa itong ginagamit natin live stream system. Baka mamaya. Ayoko muna sumabog yung PC ko habang nagla-live stream. So, pansamantala. Ang comments, teka lang, lumampas na yung comments, I have to scroll, no. Parang may CyanogenMod mod yung Spectra. So here's the Star Mobile Night Spectra. Bili ka natin si browser. Mali, dali lang. May specific button para bumalik sa web browser. Yan. So here's the Star Mobile Night Spectra. Actually, may icon dyan na pag nagano ka, nag-scroll, pinindot mo yung home, ano yan? Yung pampili ng, sa interface ng Spectra, yung kinalikot ko kasi siya eh. Wala akong Spectra ngayon, obviously. Wala tayong unit. But, the Spectra, nung kinalikot ko siya at the launch, pag hinanap mo yung parang yung launcher niya, kasi di ba pwede mo palitan yung launcher ng mga phones, the Spectra's launcher icon is a CyanogenMod icon. So it's a CyanogenMod base, hindi nila pinatan yung icon. Kung gusto man, kung hindi man nila ba, kung balak man nilang palitan yung o hindi nila ayaw nilang pahalatang CyanogenMod siya. It's a CyanogenMod kasi makita mo sa icon ng kanyang launcher. Ang ganda ng Firefly Intense Metal, sino to? Si Porto, Porto Cili. Kaya lang outdated much na yung specs. Ang tagal na si Firefly Intense Metal. Old school, usapan na yun. Alpab. Ano yung Alpab? Oh, please. Aaron Ballesteros, ayun, lumabas na medyo naglag lang PC ko sa na. Good evening, guys. Ano po yung BTS? Chat po. Mahirap na yan pag may guest. Oh, mahirap talaga. hindi pwede to pag may guest, guys. Sobrang sasabog ang PC ko pag may guest. Hindi ko pwedeng igalaw ko nga to. Sandali lang. Igagalaw natin itong... Oh, mali. Igalaw natin si comments box. Tago na. Ayan. Okay, good. Para mas marami magkasyang comments. Hindi sayang yung space na sa hindi pwede Skype. Ano ba? Hindi. Asakit. Hindi nyo kasi gets kung gaano kasakit ng ulo mag-stream ng Skype. Yung kausap mo sa Skype, kukuhanin mo yung audio and video niya, ipapasok mo pa sa live stream at i-upload mo pa. Bukod pa sa ina-upload mo yung video mo, ina-upload mo pa yung ina-upload mo pa yung video and audio niya, and pahirapan sa software yung ipapatch in mo yung audio and video from Skype. Bukod pa doon, imbis habang nag-upload ako sa YouTube ng video and audio ko at video and audio niya ng mga ibang host, yung video and audio ko na ina-upload sa YouTube, ina-upload ko rin sa kanila via Skype. Dalawa-dalawa pa yun. Tapos yung patch in ng video and audio na yun, sakit sa ulo yun. That's near impossible. Na talaga ang daming mong criss-cross mo yung wires, criss-cross ko yung microphone, double microphone if I have to, ganun, whatever. Kuya, ano po ang BTS? BTS is a big time show. Nakikita mo yung logo dito? Yeah, the big time show. Yeah. That's our welcome to the show pala. This is the big time show. Sana yung natin. Welcome to the Big Time Show. It is Saturday, November 14, 2015. Katatapos lang ng Friday the 13th. Anong araw nangyari yung terrorism attack sa Paris? Was it Friday the 13th or today, as in 14th? Kasi kung Friday the 13th, baka medyo may... Hindi eh. Today yun eh, 14th eh. Ang Big Time Show po is a live YouTube tech discussion at podcasts. Usapang teknolohiya, gadgets, mobile devices dito sa Pilipinas. Ano to? Yun, Kakao Boys. Kakao Boys! Cowboys. Yan. Pero ayan ha. Magpaka ano na kayo. Mag-chat na kayo. Lahat na lang gusto nyo sabihin sa Kakao Boys. Makikita dito. Asan yung isa kong pang... Oh my God. Nakalimutan ko yung ano. Ayoko sirain yung ano. Pwede na siguro. Wait lang ha. Wait lang. Papatayin ko yung camera dito. Configure. Hindi. Nandito lang yung configure. Eh. Naiwan ko dito. No. Wala. Okay. Configure. Okay, there we go. Wait, that's a camera. Eh, yeah. All right. So, i-focus natin. Manual focus ito. Eh. Yan. Tapos kasi pa auto-focus, nawawala siya sa focus. Eh. Yan. Shoutout po sa mga ka-BTS, sabi ni Aaron. Ayan, sa Kakao Boys. Anyway, what's with the Cherry prepaid? Anong perks nung mag-Cherry prepaid? Yeah, pag-uusapan din natin yan today. Ano ba specs ng PC ko? I have a i5 and laptop lang gamit ko. I just have a i5 laptop. It's a combination of kung ano-ano apps yung pinapa-undown ko para lang gumana to. And, syempre, nagsistream pa ako sa BTS, di ba? So, medyo masakit lang sa ulo. But, this is the future kung kailangan. Dahil hindi umaandar yung comment system ng Hangouts. Alright, so let's see. Ano ba, kuya, alam ko na alinis ang existing SIM ng Cherry Mobile Astro. Alinis? Ano alinis? Today yun, attack sa Paris. Yeah, yeah, sad. That's why meron tayong hashtag doon. Pray for Paris, yan yung nakikita ko sa Twitter, so ginaya ko lang. Welcome to the show. Maraming ano, very interesting week this week. Actually, maraming devices. There's a lot of devices na nag-launch. Hindi ko na, yung code ko, hindi ko na napapakita. So, the devices that launched is, let's do this. Mag-experiment ako sa ating setup. Tingnan natin kung hindi sasabog yung computer ko. Okay? There we go. Let's share a screen picture. Refresh. Yes. No, that's not what I want. This one. Yes. Okay. Bam. No, that's not it. No. Windows for refresh. Okay. What? Bakit? Oh, there we go. Boink. Okay. Is that too big? Is that too small? That's what she said. Okay. Ang topic sa atin for today, actually, lakayan na nga natin. Tatarotat. Okay. Ang topic sa atin for today is there's a lot of interesting things. So, first of all, yan. So, para sa mga interesado, there's a new Cherry prepaid SIMs and stuff. And meron siyang, there's a basic phone bundle with a SIM. There's a Android phone 999 bundle. And then meron ding another double bundle, dalawang phone. Isang Android, isang ano. Hindi ko alam kung hindi sila magkapareho eh. Pero 1699. This is on top of their current Android line. Magkalabas sila ng talaga prepaid SIM. Pwede ka rin bumili ng SIM mismo. Which is very weird. Kind of the newest endeavor ni Cherry Mobile. Pag-usapan natin yan mamaya kasi mas marami akong details. Mas maraming pag-usapan natin yung mga presyo ng SIM, presyo ng text, presyo ng data. Meron tayong mga pictures nung kanilang leaflet and stuff like that. Plus, meron tayong unit. Ito. Yan. The Big Time Bundle sponsored by Big Time Show. This is yung 999. Nandito yung unit sa loob. Actually, hindi ko pa siya nakakalikot. But, konti, nakalikot ko konti. Pero it's a very, very basic phone na kung nagtatanong lang man lang din kayo, I have to say, the Big Time Bundle, this one, this phone right here, ito yung specs sa likod, no? Ibaguhin ko yung focus. Let's macro focus that thing. There we go. It's a single core 1 gigahertz processor. Dual SIM 512 MB RAM. Internal memory pala 'yon. Ano yung RAM niya? My god, that's specs though. That's specs. alam niyo guys, yung pag binuksan mo sa box ito, yung this Big Time Bundle. Yung mismong kaka-unbox ko sa kanya, sinubukan ako mag-install ng Clash of Clans, hindi na kasha sa memory. So, ganun kaliit yung memory niya. Before this show, gusto ko sanang lagyan ng micro SD card and testing ko kung may pwede mag-install ng Clash of Clans. Kaya lang, hindi ko nagawa kasi medyo busy. But, it's a single core 1 GHz. Sobrang ano na talaga, sobrang baba na talaga. Siguro sa review na lang or sa unboxing gagawa tayo ng ano. Unless, pipilitin talaga natin mag-install. May micro SD ako dito, hindi ko alam kung may laman or not. So that's one of our topics, the Cherry Mobile Prepaid. There's also a new Star Mobile product called the Star Mobile Night Spectra. The dalawa yung rear-facing camera. It's actually, I have to say, I like the Star Mobile Night Spectra. It's a nice design. Ang ganda ng 5.5-inch display niya. It's AMOLED. The 5.5-inch display is AMOLED, making it really, really nice. I think it's probably one of the best looking ano. Siguro magugulat ako kung hindi nanalo ng awards Spectra. Although wala tayong review unit, so I guess hindi naman natin pwedeng dayain yun. Kung wala tayong unit, hindi naman masyadong mapapaglaruan. But the design is really, really nice. So kailangan natin ma-ano yan, pag-usapan ng konti. Plus the dual rear camera, kung may tanong kayo, pag-usapan natin. And then we have a lot of Lenovo phones. Actually, three of them. And we have two of them hands-on. First of all is Lenovo Vibe S1 with dual front cam naman. Dual front cam. So kung yung isa, dual rear cam, the Lenovo Vibe S1 has dual front cam. So I guess, hindi ko alam kung ano mas importante sa inyo. Dual rear cam or dual front cam. And surprisingly, si Lenovo pa yung gumawa ng dual front cam. You would think si Star Mobile mauna sa dual front cam kasi medyo mas kilala ko, mas ano yun, mas mahilig sa selfie si Star Mobile kaysa sa Lenovo. I don't know. But yeah, dual front cam si Lenovo S1. But I think mas gusto ko itong P1 and P1M. So which we have right here. So tatanggalin ko itong picture na to. Here is the Lenovo Vibe P1. And then magic. Yan. Full screen. Star Mo ano sa Star Trek? Yung ano? On screen. Hail. So baba natin to para hindi mahirapan. Here's the Lenovo Vibe P1 with a 5,000 milliamp hour battery, Snapdragon 615, and NFC and what do you call this? Fast charging. Pero P1 and P1M has fast charging. Hindi lang nasisira yung aking ano, stand. Yeah. It has fast charging and it has fingerprint sensor. So for example, inon ko siyang ganyan. Nakalaki yan eh. So, pero pwede natin lagyan ng finger doon, ng may thumb. And badadam! Wow! It has a fingerprint sensor. So, I think this is a nice phone for people looking for a mid-range na may finger or large battery na mid-range. And then we have the P1M, which is a, how much is this? P1M. 7,999. Ito ang pinaka-interesting product for me right now. Well, I mean, ako mas fan ako ng P1 even though medyo mahal siya or what. It's not, the P1 is not for everyone in my opinion. But the P1M is probably the first phone I've seen that uses a new quad-core MediaTek processor called the 6735P. And it's a 64-bit quad-core processor from MediaTek at 1 gigahertz. This is ano sobrang weird. But the thing is, it's super smooth. Nakakapagano. So parang this is, it's like going back to the mid the sa 2013 ages of a quad core MediaTek. But it's now a 64 bit in 1 gigahertz. Okay, ang bilis niya pero 1 gigahertz siya. But anyway, this is gonna be priced at 7,999. 5-inch HD display. 8 megapixel camera sa likod, di masya, it's gonna be okay. Pakita ko yung pictures mamaya. 4,000 milliamp hour battery. So 5,000 and then 4,000 milliamp hour battery. So if you want a long lasting phone, ito medyo okay to. The wiggle wiggle, wiggle wiggle, wiggle wiggle, wiggle wiggle wiggle. Let's see, what's the comment look like? Wiggle wiggle. Hey Gwen for the win, what's up? What's the comments here? Alpub. Ano po yung beat? Okay, Skype na. Ano po specs ng PC mo? Ay, nabasa ko na yan. Alisin? Ano yung alisin? Ano yung aalisin? Kike Mabraka, good evening kuya. Naninibago ako sa comment system pero cool. Yeah, ako, hindi ko rin. If mas gusto ko yung ano, mas gusto ko yung dating comment system kasi ang comment system dati, sorry, natama ako yung microphone. Yung comment system dati, lumilitaw after na play na yung after natapos yung stream. So, gusto ko 'yun kasi nababasa ko lahat ng comments if ano. Eh yung kan ganito, medyo mahirap nang balikan yung comments later on kung gusto ko man. Erno Campos, sa mga gusto ng mag-iPhone, wag magluho ng malaki kasi may Japan lock na iPhone na mura. Yeah, well, wag na kayo bumili ng mga medyo regional iPhones. Erno Campos, unang hirit daw. Kyle Daniel Subron, maglalabas daw po smartphone ang Pepsi. Yeah, in China magkakaroon. Dito sa Pilipinas, I don't think so. Aaron Ballesteros, ipon muna bago iPhone. Erno Campo, iPhone na lang. Aaron Ballesteros, natutuwa ako sa setup ng BTS ngayon. Refreshing. Hey, thank you. The Breath Crafter, Brethren Pablo, sana wala ng incognito para wala ng nanonood ng porn. Hoy, ano masama sa incognito, pare? Erno Campo, yeah, Daniel Subron, kahapon, bili pa mo kayo niyan iPhone. Brethren Pablo, unbox mo na please. How much yan, kuya? Jassy Jana, hello? Erno Campo, I don't know, pero nababaduyan na ako sa mga pahirit at gimmick ng Cherry Mobile ngayon. Diba? I'm still a Cherry fanboy though. It's just ang dami na lang gimmick. I guess that's true. Nawawala yung... ano ba? There's a certain amount of nawawala na yung original... original na... Galingan nga natin ng hot ito. Yan. Yung original na point, original na target market or target devices ng Cherry. Because, I mean, magaganda pa rin yung Cherry devices, but yung there are products nga na parang hindi tumatama sa gusto ng masa sometimes. Anyway, let's see here. Brethren Pablo, kuya, anong laptop? Windows tablet, around 5,000. Pang gift ko lang for myself. Kailangan ko rin eh, please. Anong laptop, Windows tablet for 5,000? This guy. Yeah. This is the Cherry Mobile Maya. Maya. Cherry Mobile Maya Tab. Maya Smart Tab is $4,999. Android / Windows PC siya, so that's good. Gwen for the win, tapos na po ba kayo mag-review ng Flare S4 Plus? Wala po akong unit ng Flare S4 Plus. Unfortunately, we only have the Flare S4, which is somewhere here. Nakabaon doon sa mga kandot. I don't have a Flare S4 Plus, unfortunately. So, hindi ko alam kung ma-review natin yan. If we can get a unit, mapahiram tayo, then ma-review natin. Alright, so, should we start talking? I mean... Ang aga pa, 10:30 pa lang, guys. Sana iba. Sa mga old school BTS, ano to eh. Early hours pa lang ngayon ng show eh, kung tutuusin eh. Let's see. I guess yung hindi ko lang nakikita dito sa live stream is yung how many people are... Brethren Pablo, ano na po ang price ng Alpha Play at Alpha Morph? Mas mababa na. They're very affordable now. I believe Alpha Morph is under 5,000 na rin. Yeah, okay, sandali lang. Meron tayong ano dyan. mahirap puntahan dahil kasi marami akong Windows open. Sandali lang. Oh yeah, ito, 5 watching. Hindi ko kasi makikita eh. I don't have the sa Hangouts makikita ko yung ano eh. Makikita yung how many people watching. Kaya lang dito hindi ko nakikita. Oh. Maglalag kasi yung CPU ko. Sinasabi kasi ng streaming software ko kung maglalag yung stream dahil kung nahihirapan na yung CPU ko. So at that point yun, there nung sinabi kong oops, may konting red ping yung software ko, sabi niya, "Oh, you're gonna lag a little bit." Start na sir, 6 watching now. Jazzy Jana, tanong ko lang po, ano pong mas maganda sa gaming, Asus Zenfone 2 Laser or Asus Zenfone Selfie? I would say the Selfie, just by a little bit. Kyle Daniel Subron, sir, suggest nga po kayo okay na Bluetooth controller. Para saan? Para sa Android? Huwag na bumili nun. Wala namang magandang aking Android games. Brethren Pablo, paano po ginagamit ang Google on Tap? It's a contextual contextual ano. Hindi ko pa din ma-demo ngayon kasi wala pa akong hindi ko pa na-update yung Android 1 ko sa Marshmallow. But nandito na siya, hindi ko lang nagawa guys. Gusto bala ko kasi gawa ng video eh habang nag-update. Hindi ko lang alam kung ano. Mahirap mag-decide kasi may bloatware. Sus. Pareho naman yung tanong niya eh. Sabi ni Jazzy Jana, Zenfone Laser or Zenfone Selfie. Pareho lang yung bloatware nun. So, buhay pa ba ang Superior Navigator ko? Sale kasi ng 3.5. Hindi ko pa ginagamit na matagal. I think. Either binalik ko na sa Cherry Mobile yung Superior Navigator ko kasi hindi naman sa akin yun. Or nandyan siya hindi ko siya nagamit ng matagal naman. Or at least hindi ko pa ginagamit recently. So hindi ko masasabi kung ano. Yung mga review units namin usually, kung tumagal sa akin is ginagamit ko for at least 1 month. At least 1 month. Kung tumagal ah, minsan kasi binabawi agad eh. Kung tumagal yung unit, ginagamit ko for about 1 month and then doon yung report ko about the durability. I guess 1 month, yes, tumagal naman siya 1 month. But today, hindi ko na alam. I don't even remember the specs of that. Let's see here. May Nvidia Shield tablet po ba kayo? Wala. Hey, Froybel Torres, what is up? Kuya. Alright, so it's 10:34. It's very interesting. Nananibago pa rin ako sa ano natin sa live stream natin setup eh, sorry. But I guess we should maybe start the show. May nagpapaputok. And that's not me. Ding it. Alright, so actually, if you want, since parang I think we have a lot of time today, since maaga tayo nag-start and everything. I don't know kung ano, kung it's gonna be boring or not, but what we'll do is we'll unbox the Cherry Mobile, the big time bundle. Okay, so we'll ayusin natin ang konti focus. Ayoko magkamali siya. Let's have it auto focus and sorry, kailangan ko igalaw yung mga windows ko. Let's bring up the exposure. Kaya na maglalag ng konti. Yeah. Yun yung lago. Pag tinasa natin yung... anyway, mas gusto ko yung mataas yung brightness ng konti. Tanggalin natin si comments. There we go. See? High tech. All right. So here's the Cherry Mobile Big Time Bundle. This is the Astro. Ang ganda na ano, pwede mong i-ano. Ayusin natin yung focus ng konti. Bah, tingnan nyo yan. Kita-kita yung basura ko sa likod. Linaw ng kuha. Here's the Cherry Mobile Astro Big Time Bundle. And it's a prepaid phone na may prepaid SIM na sa loob. Here's the phone itself. There we go. Wabam! That size though. There we go. Kita nyo naman? Comment nyo nga kung kita nyo. Eros yan. Nandyan yung galing Paris. Let's start. Present. Please po, agahan nyo po ang streaming nyo. Please like 8 o'clock. Hindi ko alam kung pwede natin baguhin yung ating schedule muna. But so far. 10:30 po kasi talaga ang time ni Sir. Pwede ba yung pang Minecraft PE? Alin? See? Anong phone? Di siguro kaya Minecraft. Ito, si Astro? No way. Kalat ng room. Yeah, hindi ko nga nasaran yung ano yung cabinet ko sa likod eh. Go unboxing sana every BTS meron. Hindi ka... baka mainip kayo sa unboxing, guys. Kasi hindi naman exciting pag-unboxing. So, totoo lang in my opinion. Kasi maraming sinesetup. There's a lot of setup, at least in terms of getting the phone ready to be yung played with. Isipin mo, unbox ka, wala kang mga Antutu, wala kang mga ano. Autofocus na natin. Alaha Antutu and everything. So here's the Cherry Mobile Astro. I-on na natin. Hindi ka prepared. Wala kang camera samples. Wala kang naka-install na apps pag nag-unbox ka. You have to think about that. Kasi alam mo, mumurahin ka ng ano eh. Mga commenters dito sa ano sa Pilipinas, ano eh. Sobrang over ano eh. Over, what do you call this? Oh my God, wala atang baterya. Naiwan ko ata na kaunto. Ah, next. Good. What do you call this? Over-entitled ang mga commenters sa Pilipinas. Alam nyo na yon. You know this. You know this. Nice gift, pang gift sa Pasko ni Cherry Mobile Astro. Now, that's a good point. But tatandaan nyo yung SIM na nasa loob nito is Cherry Mobile prepaid SIM. So let's talk about the Cherry Mobile prepaid. Here's my web browser. Ba-ba-bam! Ah, ang ganda, high-tech. Hindi nga lang 720p yung ating stream, though. So what we'll do is actually just read some of these information para ano, magets yung usapan ng Cherry Mobile prepaid. So ito yung start ng event. We live blogged it, so hindi naman importante makita yung iba dito. So here's the graphics on the prepaid, the text, internet, whatever, 3G. So they're using the Globe, ano, Globe Network. There it is. There's the phone. Battery is low. Wala pa, saan pa? Power bank, sandali lang. Congratulations, your mobile number has been loaded with 300 pesos. Oh my God. Niload na ako. Dali lang. Sorry, hindi ako prepared. Nasa right side yung ano niya. Ah, nasa left side yung kanya charging. Okay. Come on. Kumagat ka. Ah, baligtad. There we go. Alright. So here's the Astro. Baba natin brightness. Oh my God. Okay. Brightness. There we go. Taas pa rin, ano? Let's change the camera settings. The webcam settings. Pwede na yan. Pinakamababa na yan eh, I think. Settings. Ayan na yung hands-on niya. Sandali, baba pa natin exposure. Ito na yung hands-on natin, Kuyas. Set the focus. Sorry, maraming technical stuffs going on. Para mag... Ayan. Alright. So, let's go... Personal? No. Asan yun? More network, no, that's my device display. There it is. No, back 1 gigahertz single core processor. But guys, oh, nakatodo pa ba na eh? That's the lowest the brightness can go. It's not an IPS display or anything. Tanggalin natin yung web browser. There's the Astro. Obviously, hindi makikita kasi madilim because this display is next level. But to be honest, this is not bad. may load ako. Oh yeah. Hanggang January 25, 2016. Oh yeah. Sinong gusto makipag-textan, textmate? With my Cherry prepaid text Astrophone. Hindi ko alam kung maganda siguro para regalo. So here's the my Astro. Babalik na tayo sa medyo may maliwaliwanag na ano. Yan. Yeah, medyo maliwanag lang. Okay. All right. Let's see here. Anong comment? Sorry. Comments. Let's see. Re-review nyo po yung Kata box, yung Android setup box ng Kata. Matend po ako ng event noon pero wala ka tayong review unit kasi sa totoo lang, there's a bunch of bloggers na minomonopolize si Kata. So, wala tayong magagawa doon. Kuya, nababasa niyo po ba ito? Yes, huwag kang magalala. Nababasa ko yan. Kyle Subron, para pong SIM na Apple, may ginawa din po sila. Pero 5 po ata, pwede na network. Yan ba yung 2.8-inch ang screen size, Kuya? Akin na lang po yung G1 nyo. Kuya, expanda po yan. Cherry Mobile, 32GB. If you ask me, hindi ko kabisado lahat ng specs or anything. It's a single core 1 gigahertz processor. Buti nga may wireless update. Eh. Check natin, baka may update. Check. Wala to, ay, wala akong, hindi ko pa nalaro na ano sa wifi ko. Ah, mali na pindot ko. Pero smooth, guys. Sa totoo lang, wait, baba natin ulit yung brightness para makita yung interface. Alright. Ito nga. Yeah. Yung interface niya, tignan nyo, smooth to. File manager. Videos. Tignan natin yung camera. Ito yung camera. Yun, okay na siya. Siyempre, mababa yung brightness, diba? Oh, ha? Ano yung camera niya? Tignan natin. Let's see. Android KitKat 4.4.2 dual SIM 512 MB memory 2 gigs rear cam 2 megapixel rear camera VGA front camera Bluetooth 2.1 it says here 3G. May 3G siya na 1900 2100. The battery is 1100 milliamp hours and may micro SD slot. So actually, the thing I want to show you, actually patayin natin yung ano, yung phone. Power off. Guys, this is probably one of the smoothest single core 1 gigahertz devices I've ever used. Hindi ko alam kung bakit. Siguro maganda lang yung talaga yung software customization nila. Yung SIM nito, yung Cherry prepaid SIM, hindi mo matatanggal. Ayan yung SIM 2, ayan yung micro SD slot. Wala yung ano, wala yung lalagyan ng Cherry SIM. So, may isa siyang SIM slot na gamit na. At hindi mo pwedeng tanggalin. And yung sinabi ko ng screen size niya no. Ang gagawin ko dito, i-install lang, lalagyan ko ng micro SD para lang malagyan natin ng CPU Z ng Antutu ganun kasi hindi siya makakapag-install eh. Sandali, actually kung gusto niyo, bukan natin. Pero for 999, may prepaid SIM ka na. Yun nga lang, syempre naka-lock sa network yun, diba? Sa kung anong network nila yun. I don't know kung... So, pag-usapan natin yung kanilang konting ano ba to? Programs or something. Medyo mas okay ng konti sa Samsung Galaxy Y, sabi ni Daniel Subron. Baka nga, most likely. Patingin po ng Alpha Shift nyo, please. Wala akong Alpha Shift. Wala rin akong Alpha Morph. I have Alpha Play. Nandito. Walang baterya. On. Okay, so let's talk about the hindi, wala kasi battery. I mean, low bat. So, charge muna natin and let's talk about the thing. Technical difficulties. Yan yung problem pag hindi handa yung produkto para i-demo. Okay naman, tama. Tama yung pwesto ng baterya and everything. Okay, so malamang ayaw niya lumabot dahil hindi pa siya na-charge ng tama. Alright, so there's the phone. There's, ayan, nag-boot na siya. Okay. Don't fall. Okay. So, balik tayo sa web browser. Toink. Yan. Okay. So, nag-launch sila si Michael V yung kanilang endorsement, sir. There it is. And si Ernest Kuhn nandiyan to ano, ito si Michael V, sumasayaw. Oh, ang ganda ng ano natin ah. Ang ganda ng live stream natin, pati yung mga video gumawa. Oh my God. Ito yung box, nakita nyo, ito yung unit. Ito yung unit na disubukan natin. My God, ang ganda ng ano natin, live stream natin guys, 30 FPS and everything. Alright, so, ito yung magandang pag-usapan. Okay, let's look at this, these plans. So may bonus load siya, hindi ko naiintindihan pa masyado yun. You dial *139 to register for the offers. May 10 pesos internet. Ah, hindi mabasa, no? Sorry, hindi pala mabasa. Ang pinaka-interesting dito is the 199 pesos. Ito. 500 meg internet ata to for 30 days or something like that. So, at least pwede kang mag-ano eh. Pwede kang mag-Clash of Clans dito eh. Most likely. May unlimited text ba siya? Unlimited chat. No, I don't want unlimited chat. CM Talk 30. Ano ba ito? Ang layo kasi nung... Ay, wait, nasa ba yun? Ito, ito na lang. Sorry, sorry, sorry. Akala ko madadala ng ano eh. Akala ko madadala ng web browser yung ano. Yung ating flyer. Pero kailangan pala talaga ng malapit. Ano, ito. Ito na lang tayo. All right, so where is it? There you go. Text. Unlimited text to all networks for 7 days is 99 pesos. Ayusin natin focus. CM only 15. Unlimited text to other Cherry prepaid subscribers for 1 day is 5 pesos. All network 7 days is 99. Ano ba dito? Combo, call text and internet or something. Wala pa lang ano. Wala pa 1 month na unlimited text. Here's the... Ano to? 10 minutes calls for all networks for 1 day, 30 pesos. So, ang pinaka ano siguro dito is 7 days unlimited text to all networks. Yan ang pinaka magagamit mo dyan for 100 pesos. That's not bad. Hindi ako ganun kalakas mag-text though. So, yun na yun. Here's the phone itself. Pasok tayo sa wire. Oh, namatay siya. My God. Sorry. Hindi tayo talaga prepared. Maybe we should move on eventually. Yung Alpha Play na lang. Patingin po ng Maya Smart Tab. Pinakita ko na yung Maya Smart Tab. Here. Wala rin baterya. Hindi ko pa nagagamit recently. Hi mga kabite. Sorry ngayon lang ako naka-online. Milo, what's up? Whoa, layo. Layo news, Sir Alexi. Ano yung layo? Andito lang ako. Andito. I'm here. malayo yung webcam, yes. Pero at least may webcam. Dalawa yung webcam natin ngayon. Hindi yung parang paisa-isa lang. All right, so nataranta ako eh. So here we go. Back to the web browser. Here we go. So yung products nila, 500 megabyte data for 30 days. Here yung ito yung interested ako. Eh. Pang Clash of Clans yan, 200 pesos for 30 days of 500 megs data, which is not bad. Hindi wag ka lang mag-download daw. Siguro YouTube bubos agad to. Ito yun. Text to other networks, one per text. Ito yung call and text rates. Eh. Sorry ba yan? Paano magpa-load? Yun. So, how and where to load? May denomination sa Cherry prepaid outlets. 50, 100 pesos, 300 pesos, tsaka 500 pesos. Pwede rin magpa-load sa auto-load max retailers and stuff like that. Hindi ko alam kung ano yung fair use policy nila. Fair use policy kung meron silang maximum data allowance or something like that or mag-ano ka na. Gusto ko pa rin yung Vine eh. Maganda manorin yung Vine dito sa live stream. Nakakatawa. You know, Vine ni Michael B. Alright, so I don't know kung merong, ano eh, may extra tanong dito sa about the Cherry Mobile prepaid eh. The Cherry Mobile prepaid, yes, is powered by Globe. The network is from Globe. Walang mismong cell site si Cherry. Nagamit sila cell sites ng Globe. So I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. Hindi ko pa exactly alam yung wording nila sinabi kung sino yung nag-handle ng data sino ano. Most likely si Globe pa rin yung ano. Pero hindi ko alam kung sino yung parent yung mas malaking company or sino yung may bigger stake in this ano, kung Globe ba or Cherry Mobile ba. From what I understand, I guess nagsasublease leasing si Cherry Mobile ng ano internet lines or data lines or call lines sa Globe. I don't know, so totoo lang hindi ako masyadong ano dyan sa ganyang political stuff eh, but or organizational stuff, but I just need para sa akin consumer only lang ang pinag-iisipan ko. Eh. So for the consumer, yes, it's a new brand of telco na powered by Globe. So that may be good, that may be bad. Baka mostly bad, I don't know. But I think the rates are affordable. So, yun lang naman yung ano dito. And I guess we can check the phone again. Bago tayo matapos, here's the phone again. It's charging. Patayin natin si browser. Pagawin natin yung exposure. So, kailangan ko mag-login sa wifi, sorry. Ang maganda dito, I think pwede magbayad, bumili ng apps with the load, I think. Kailangan ko, ito nga lang. Sorry. Hindi ako na-prepare. Wi-Fi. Laging sa Wi-Fi. Samahan. Hopefully, wala akong napitot na mali doon sa password. Yeah, man. Bullet 8. Let's see, ano bang usapan niya? Ano bang nag-uusap dyan? Well, ba yan? Available na po ba yan nationwide, Kuya? I don't think they said kung kailan siya. Ano. Tingnan, basahin natin yung ano yung press release nila. Ilan po ba internal ng Astro? Hindi ko nga makita eh. Kasi ano, ang hirap nga nung ano. Hindi natin ma-installan eh. Available starting December 1, 2015. You can purchase the Cherry Mobile prepaid. You can purchase the Cherry Mobile prepaid phone kit bundle, Cherry prepaid SIM, and Cherry prepaid load cards at all Cherry Mobile outlets. Reload for as low as 5 pesos at all Cherry Mobile outlets and from Globe Max retailer. So, kahit sa mga tindahan ng Cherry Mobile pala, pwede kang mag-ano. Nakapasok na ba ako sa Wi-Fi? Yes. Okay. So, I think we should be able to see yung kaya lang ha, my device. Sige natin. Power saving? No, that's not it. There's no more. Okay, more. Storage. There we go. Here. Yeah. So the storage says we have a maximum of phone memory 512 megabytes. The remaining is 46 point 46 point ano. Looks like pwede natin baguhin yung preferred install location, so that's good. For 90.16 megs yung total ang available out of the box. Wala pa ako ini-install dito is 47 meg. Kahit ata Twitter hindi magkakasya dyan. The RAM is 256 megabytes. 256 megabytes of RAM. Yan na, you heard it here first, ha? 256. So, pwede natin install na ng SD card and then doon ako mag-i-install later on. Pero right now, wala tayong may install. Hindi ko lalagyan ng SD card. What else do you want to know? Kasi hindi, kung wala tayong ma-install na apps, hindi ko malalagyan ng Antutu or anything para matesting yung CPU or whatever. At least meron siyang Bluetooth. At least we know that. Meron siyang tethering, Wi-Fi. Let's see, power saving management. Backup reset. Ano ba ito? More storage apps, printing, accessibility. About phone. May minsan may specifications dito. Kernel, build number. So, can we go developer mode? Alright. Do you like status? Wait, no. Status. What? Okay. Ah, there it is. Wi-Fi. Walang processor or anything. Kasi minsan may processor information dito sa ano eh. Sa mga status and stuff eh. Astro system update. Check for updates. Currently up to date. Okay. So that's ano. Kakalikutin ko na lang to later on kasi wala nga tayong micro SD, wala tayong ma-install at all, ever, period, zero talaga, zero, zero talaga. There's absolutely nothing you can do with that phone without installing an SD card because of the small memory. Alright, so let's refresh the comments. Hindi ko na pala kailangan refresh yung comments. Malayo sa webcam. Available na po ba yan? Ilan po internal ng Astro? Yan, according to ano, 512 MB internal, 256 megabytes of RAM. Tapos na po ba yung topic para sa Lenovo? Interesting kasi. Ah, parating pala tayo sa Lenovo. So, tapos na po tayo sa ating Cherry Mobile topic. I really want to know if the Cherry Mobile Astro can run a Clash of Clans. Yun lang naman yung importante sa most na bibili nito. So yeah, I guess that's it. I don't know, mukhang wala nagtatanong tungkol sa Cherry Mobile Astro. So, I guess we'll finish up on that topic. Install ako na ng SD card later on. Hindi na ako, wala na akong SD card sa ngayon. Usually, wala na akong pinaprepare kasi hindi na ganun kaano yung telepono. And I have to find out kung interesado pa rin yung tao sa Astro. Kasi it's kind of a niche product na it will only cater to people looking for the Cherry prepaid SIM. Although, kung lahat ng retailers may Cherry prepaid, then most likely lahat ng tao, oh my god! Sorry. Most likely a lot maraming tao will be interested in Cherry prepaid because pag nakita sila nila sa tindahan, they'll be super curious pa rin about these products. Because ganun talaga eh, people are interested pag nakita nila sa tindahan. Here's the other new Lenovo phones, the P1 and the P1 Mini. Don't worry guys, buhay pa sila. let's see. Balik natin si comments. Pa-pa-pow! Ayan. Alright. Ito, may mga tanong pa. May kasama ko bang earphone, kuya, at least for listening to music na lang? Paano mo lalagyan ng music? Wala na. Okay, lalagyan mo na. Hindi. I understand. Lalagyan mo na SD card. And then lalagyan mo doon yung music. Let's see what's inside the box. Actually, may isa pang unit, may isa pa tayong bago eh, PlaySpark, but wala, I don't know if we have time. Here's the box. Balik tayo sa box. Alright. Paperwork. Screen protector na may tinanggal kong dating transportation protection. Medyo makapal-kapal na manual, surprisingly. Oh, sorry. Medyo makapal-kapal na manual, surprisingly. Meron siyang headphones. Charger, USB cable, and then headphones. So. Yeah. Okay, that's the headphones. Okay. Ang kalat niya. Ang dami niyang plastic. Okay, alright. Nakapagod tong setup ko. Drop test ko ya on Lenovo phones. How much po si Vive S1? Alright, so let's talk about the Lenovo phones. Let's first talk about the specs and then I'll tell you about what I think on the few of them. So, back to web browser mode. Alright, so first of all, I'm actually going to do this. S1, here we go. Maybe I can do this. Wow. All right. Guys, nawiwili ako sa ano? Nawiwili ako sa technology na ginagamit natin. Ang problema lang, pag nawiwili ako dito, maiinip kayo kasi lahat na lang ng pwede kong gawin, gagawin ko. And then hindi na ganun ka-entertaining yung show kasi puro na lang ako eksperimento. All right, so here's the Lenovo Vive S1. Here's one of the first few the units ng Lenovo. And the S1 is actually kahit di ko na ginawa yun, pwede ko na klikan dito, makita niyo rin. The S1 is their selfie, I guess hindi, I don't know if they're calling it a flagship, but it's a selfie phone. It's got dual front-facing cameras. Here we go. 8 megapixel and 2 megapixel. Now, dapat inuna natin si Star Mobile sa totoo lang. But since it's tatlo yung Lenovo, unahin na natin si Lenovo para matapos tayo agad sa main topics. Star Mobile also has a dual rear camera phone, as you can see right here. Dual rear camera phone. Nauna nag-launch by one day si Star Mobile, but so wag niyo sabihin mamaya pag tinapik natin si Star Mobile yung gumaya. But Lenovo, instead of the dual rear camera, they're using a dual front camera selfie. So 2 megapixel dito, 8 megapixel dun sa isa. So ang ano talaga siya, selfie centric phone siya. It's priced at 15,999, which is a little steep in my opinion. And it's not a Snapdragon 615, it's a 1.7 GHz octa-core 6752. Now, the thing is that 6752, come on, there we go. That MediaTek 6752 is also being used by another phone like the Lenovo A7000 Plus, which is only 8,000 pesos, mind you. 8,000 pesos ang Lenovo A7000 Plus to have the same processor as the Lenovo Vibe S1, which is a little, you know, kind of a lot of difference in price. But, you know, I guess may point silang pinapa ano dito. It's 15,999. And also another phone that uses it, Cherry Mobile Flare X, Alcatel Flash Plus, but the Flash Plus is using 1.5 GHz, not 1.7. The original Flare X is 1.7 MediaTek 6752. And Meizu M1 Note is also, the original Meizu M1 Note is the 1.7 GHz MediaTek 6752. So, historically, yung prices ng devices that use this processor, the 6752 1.7 octa-core, is under 10,000. Under 10,000 pesos. So, yun, I guess, doon ako masasabi medyo nagkamali sila. Dito sila medyo nagkamali because I think that's a little too much for that. Balik natin si comments. Hindi pala gumagalaw yung video mo sa YouTube. What? Talaga? Sorry. So anyway, hindi ko sinasabing pangit yung processor na to. But the historically, the devices that use this processor hasn't been the most highest end or the even mid range. It's actually a very good processor. I like it, but it's not, you know, it doesn't command, I guess, the 16,000. But ang inahabol nila is a lot of the other specs. It's got a full HD 5-inch Gorilla Glass 3 display. It's running Android 5.0 Lollipop. Hindi ko alam yung skin, but most likely it's a reskinned Lenovo Vibe UI. The rear camera is 13 megapixel PIDAF, face detection autofocus sa likod, and then yun na nga yung sinasabi kong 8 megapixel plus 2 megapixel dual front cam. Now, if you are asking what the dual front cam is for, it's the same with the Star Mobile Spectra, and if you're not familiar with that, basically, the 8 megapixel is the one that takes your pictures up front. But the 2 megapixel is it helps in determining depth. Nakakatulong siya sa depth perception. So for example, sa Asus Zenfone Laser or lahat ng mga laser autofocus devices, thinking out that. So lahat ng mga autofocus device, laser autofocus devices, the extra laser or extra yung detection material or whatever allows for the camera to find out gaano kalayo yung subject. Kasi kung dalawa yung mata mo, or dalawa yung sensor niya, kung saan nakikita yung dalawang mata, makikita niya, ganito yung... By seeing kung gaano kalayo siya in between. Kunwari, ito. Sa mata ko, versus... mahirap explain, ano? since hindi siya same point in hindi siya same point on camera, magkalayo sila ng konti, it will find out the difference between the shot ng left, the shot ng right, and yung difference nun, it tells them how far the subject is. Because the closer it is, the more magkaiba yung difference, magkalayo yung dalawang product, the subject. So, it allows them to know how far the subject is, which part of the shot is the background, and stuff like that, which same with the Star Mobile Spectra, it will allow for them to know which part of the body is the person and which is my background, for example. ang ginagam ang gamit niyan sa front facing camera way is because it will know where's the background. So kung gusto mo, there is an application in the phone to blur the background because it knows where the background is. Meron pa siyang way na pipindutin mo, i-highlight niya yung buong katawan mo sa paligid. Which is a great way to cut out people. Or a great way to, for example, may background ka ng beach. Gusto mo magpakita na nasa beach ka. And then mag-front-facing camera ka ng Lenovo Vibe S1. Alam niya kung nasan yung, ano, yung cutout mo. Kunwari, nasa CR ka na. Nag-selfie ka ng CR. Wait. Maandar pa ba yung screen? Maandar naman yung screen, right? Ano message? Ronnie Hasolino, what's up? Somebody tell me. Parang hindi. Walang nangyari. Wait. Comment ako dito. Hello? Magsalita kayo. ang use niya nga talaga is yung when the front facing camera will know, can cut out your outline. So kunwari nag-selfie ka sa CR, pwede mong i-cut out yung background mo sa selfie na yon and then transplant your picture na without the background, put it in another background like nasa beach ka or something like that. So you can say, "Ah, look at me, I'm in the beach." But normally ang ginagamit siya for blurring the background, making fancy effects like making the background black and white or something like that. So yun yung main use ng dual camera. I don't know if I need it in particular. Anong usapan dito sa kakao? Alright, wala lang. I don't know if I need that in particular, yung blurring the background cropping or compositing your face into something else. But it's a nice feature nonetheless. Still don't know if I need it. Maganda sa kanya, it's got 3 gigs of RAM. Probably that's a big bonus. 32 gigs of storage with the micro SD card slot. Wala na ka, boys. Dito pa kami, sir. Interested sa dual facing. Okay. The battery is probably one of the disappointments here. 2,500 milliamp hours, dual SIM LTE. And ang maganda dito, yung back niya, this back right here, is a curved Gorilla Glass back, which is kind of interesting kasi para siyang, parang may screen protector yung back mo. And of course, since it's a Lenovo, you got it's got a free screen protector and free case. I don't know if I necessarily ang ano kasi niya back, I think bakal ito eh talagang ultimong I guess may picture ako dito, hanapin natin yung picture natin. The Vibe S1 I think is made of metal and then there's a gold variant that mukhang iPhone-ish yung harap, which is actually kind of nice looking. No complaints here. But I don't know if it's worth 16,000 pesos, particularly because of the processor. The processor isn't necessarily the best here. I would still go for the other Lenovo's. I guess we should actually move on now kasi mukhang wala namang masyado nagtatanong tungkol sa here's some pictures here. Here's the gold. You should check out the gold. Here's the gold Lenovo Vibe S1. Ang laki pala, ang high-res pala. No? Here's the gold. Diba natin? Yeah, may pagka-iPhone siya. But, the thing I don't like, okay, the thing I really don't like here is, it's got not such a, ano, go lang kuya, blur lang yung screen. Hindi ko mabasa yung specs. Anong resolution ka nagsistream, Kikiam? Naka 480p ka ba o 360p? Gusto mo bang lakihan ko? Kasi pwede ko siyang lakihan kaya lang hindi ko makikita yung buong ano yung web browser eh. So yun ang problema ko din. Lakihan natin para sa'yo. Oink. Sorry. Oh my god. All right, so I'm gonna refresh. Oh. Okay, this should work. There we go. Yeah. Hopefully makita mo na siya. Here's the specs. Ang problema, kailangan ko na mag-scroll up and down. Vibe S1. Here's the Vibe S1. 15,999. Here's the specs. I think it's a little pricey, especially for the specs. Especially for this octa-core MediaTek 6752. But they're targeting the front-facing camera market, the selfie camera. The specs are decent. The battery is not. And that's about it. That's about all I can say about the Lenovo Vibe S1, which admittedly looks nice, but I'm not paying 16 for that. I'll buy something else. Okay na kuya, naka-auto kasi ako, sorry. So the next one is the... Wait, mali. That's not what. The next one is the Lenovo Vibe P1, and that's where we... ito, specs muna tayo, okay? The Lenovo Vibe P1 is a battery monster. Cowboys, what's up? For release na ba ang Lenovo Vibe S1? I think next week, end of October si Vibe. So, yeah. I'm pretty sure it says right there. Nasa live stream ko yun. End of November ata, or in the next, in 2 weeks ang pagkakatanda ko. So here's the Lenovo Vibe P1. It's a super huge battery at 5,000 milliamp hour. Non-removable though, but it's fast charging. Here's the picture. I also have a unit right now with me, so mamaya pakita ko sa inyo. But the key specs here, it's a quad-core Snapdragon 615 at 1.5 gigahertz, 5.5-inch Full HD Gorilla Glass 3 display na IPS. Actually, the display looks nice. It's running Android 5.1 Lollipop with Vibe UI, 13-megapixel PDAF camera, 5-megapixel front, which is standard, hindi siya dual camera. Medyo binaba nila yung RAM, naging 2 gigs na lang imbes sa 3 gigs ng S1, but 32 gigs of storage pa rin and micro SD slot. Take note, micro SD slot niya is independent. It's not yung combo micro SD nano. It's a dalawang SIM and isang micro SD. Tatlo yung slots niya. 5,000 mAh power, non-removable battery, but fast charging. Meron silang fast charger dito. Here's their fast charger. Hindi ko pa na-measure kung gaano kabilis yung non-fast charging, but the fast charger gets you full in about 1 hour 40 minutes. Most likely, sa ibang telepono, 1 hour 40 minutes is standard. But because this has 5,000 mAh, I think that's fast enough. Most likely sa normal charging, baka mabot ka ng 2.5 or 3 hours yung charging ng Vibe P1. Anyway, we'll talk about that later. It's got dual SIM LTE, USB OTG is yes, and may fingerprint scanner siya, NFC. Plus a free case and screen protector. And yung AnTuTu niya is 36,000 because it's a Snapdragon 615. And now, we'll talk about the phone itself because we have this unit right here. Up, up, up. Yeah, so the design. So, according to Taka Cowboys, mukha siya ng HTC. And yes, mukha talaga siyang HTC. Here's the unit itself. Let's do some camera adjustments to make it look better. Up, up, up. Come on. There's the focus and brightness. Wow. I like this setup. Medyo nakakatulong. All right, so here's the Lenovo Vibe P1. Like I said before, it's a 5,000 mAh battery. May case, nakakabit siya sa case ngayon. So, yun yung case niya. Tanggalin ko muna yung case. Which is, there we go. Sabi nila, hindi bakal ito. It's a kind of a bakali. I don't know kung ano, but it's nice. It feels like metal, but I don't know if it's really metal. As you can see in the front, which is probably the nicest part of this front, is all black. Parang ano nga eh, parang wala kang makitang sides dito sa ano, sa all black niyang front. Diba? Look at that. Parang wala. That's nice. I like that. I like that. All black, and then meron kang fingerprint scanner sa gitna, which is in the register sa thumb ko, so that's why it's unlocking with just holding over the fingerprint. Sometimes it doesn't succeed, but most times it does. There we go. May konting trial and error, but as long as na register mo, it's okay. Now, the thing that I don't like about the fingerprint sensor is dalawa lang yung pwede mong i-register na fingerprints. Now, hindi ako sanay sa mga fingerprint sensor mo. Hindi ko pa natetesting yung mga other devices na may fingerprint sensors. But only two fingers is a little, medyo konti para sa akin. I-register ko siya sa left thumb ko and sa right thumb. Dito. There we go. Right thumb. There we go. But if I want to use it, for example, nakapatong siya sa table, like this, normally I use a finger, like this, index finger na ganyan. So I can't do that kasi I have to use the thumb. I have to be holding the phone to unlock it with my thumb like this. Kasi nakaside, gusto ko side, yung unlock ko sa kanya sideways thumb. Anyway, it's a 5.5-inch full HD IPS display, which looks pretty nice. It's an IPS display. Maganda yung brightness niya in bright sunlight, in my opinion. It's like Samsung-y, sabi ni Porto Zili. Yeah, may pagka Samsung nga yung design niya, especially yung ano, yung pati yung fingerprint sensor niya sa ano. As you can see on the top, meron siyang notification LED. And here's the thing, binago ko yung system. Well, yung UI niya is actually Lenovo UI, but you can may preference siya. So, here's the thing. Oh, so you can use the original Vibe UI, which looks like this. Na hindi ko pa nga kinakalikot. So as you can see, yan yung ano niya. Walang app drawer sa original Vibe UI. So it looks like this. Original Vibe UI. Walang app drawer. But, surprisingly, thankfully, gusto nila akong gawing fan, they give us an option to change to stock and or at least a stock Android feeling UI. And meron na akong app drawer. There we go. Side-scrolling yung app drawer nila, which is okay lang. And as you can see, baka sabihin yung naglalag. I'll try to, shit, sorry. Para hindi siya maglag, kailangan ko ibaba yung brightness eh. So, let's see. No. So, kung nanonood kayo ng video stream, there we go. So, as you can see, hindi naman siya laggy. Even though it's a Snapdragon 615, it's not laggy. In my opinion, there's a little bit of ano, the 615 still has a little bit of jank na hindi mo maiiwasan. Plus, it's not the most powerful processor out there, at least for gaming and everything. I can still play, for example, the Modern Combat 5, and ano, so let's actually play Modern Combat 5. Hopefully, dito, you're watching this on 30 FPS, hopefully. Kasi I'm using a live stream client that streams at 30 FPS. Hindi katulad sa Google Hangouts. Sa Google Hangouts, malakas mag drop frames yung live stream ng Google Hangouts. So hopefully you can see every single frame ng ating live stream. So you can see it's loading, unfortunately. The thing I like about this as well is the volume. Malakas yung volume niya ng speakers niya. Although isa lang yung speaker sa ilalim. It's this one. And then may kain mga ano kain? Manood ka ng BTS, hoy! Alright, so here's Modern Combat 5 on the Snapdragon 615. May konti siyang stutter. Oh no! Alright. There we go, that's not so bad. May konting actual stutter. Maybe siguro sa ano. I don't know. So that's the gaming a little bit. It's Snapdragon 615. So thankfully hindi siya sobrang nagiinit, but it does warm up a little bit. It's not like the Xiaomi Mi 4i, for example. So let's talk about the design here. It's a nice kind of a metallic HTC design. Pati yung likod eh. Mukhang ang ano eh, ultra pixelist yung ano yung camera sa likod eh. And hindi siya masyado makapal. So it's 5,000 milliamp hours, pero hindi siya masyado makapal. Sabi niya, oh, it's 9.8 millimeters, which is actually not, actually a little thick. But if you think about it, you compare it with something like the Asus Zenfone Selfie, and it's not really all that thick. Pero mabigat siya. It's actually very heavy. It's kind of heavy. So there you go. That's a little bit of the, you know, parang bakal talaga yung hawak mo, although hindi ko alam kung bakal talaga siya. And there's like, yung para makita mo yung SIMs niya nandito sa ilalim. There you go. Yeah, there we go. So pag hinatak mo to, dalawang SIM slots yung lalabas, and then merong micro SD to. That's how you add the SIM and SD card. Ano pa mo sasabihin ko? There's a dedicated power saving mode dito sa left side, which is kind of weird. Kasi it makes the phone into a dumb feature phone, which is not the power saving that I want. I want the power saving to be like a smartphone, pero binaba lang yung clock speed and everything. So you can switch it on, and it'll make the phone kind of oh my god. So it'll make the phone kind of a dumb phone. Wala siyang apps to run. You can't run any Facebook or anything. I prefer apps that have, I prefer, you know, battery saving mode that has apps and Wi-Fi and stuff like that. Unfortunately, ito, baka hindi ko naman ever gagamitin yung power saving mode niya, because it's you can't do a lot of things with the power saving mode. See. Kuya, saan na yung Alex's Angels? Alex's Angels. So Jam, B-Boy, at iba pa. Hindi ko alam. Si B-Boy most likely busy ngayon. He's may racket siya ngayon eh. Si Jam, hindi ko alam. But Porto, hindi tayo pwedeng magsama ng hosts sa ganitong system, live stream system na ganito, kasi mahirap mag-setup. This is a single person live stream kung gagawa tayo ng ganitong stream. Speaking of Zenfone po, gaano po katagal life, battery life ng Zenfone 2? It's average. It's decent. Okay lang, Zenfone 2. May review tayo nun sa channel, so if you want to watch that, that's there. What else do I want to say about the price? Okay, may kodigo ako dito. So, anong gusto sabihin dito? Right B1. Only two fingerprints. Okay, so para sa mga mahilig mag-VR, hindi siya masyado maganda. The gyroscope ng VR, hindi masyado maganda. Speakers are fairly loud. Yeah. Meron akong gustong feature niya. If you go to Wi-Fi settings, and this is the only phone so far I've seen this feature, meron siyang wireless signal boost. Wireless LAN signal boost. And then pag tinignan mo dun sa Wi-Fi settings ko, let's get the focus on. There you go. May S siya dito. May S icon siya dun. And it will tell you how much it's boosting. Magkakaroon ng blue bar sa ibabaw pag binuboost niya by one blue bar. That's interesting kasi minsan malayo ka sa Wi-Fi mo. I like that feature. Ano nangyari? I like that feature. But I guess that's it. Does anybody have a question? I like the 5,000 milliamp hour battery. This is priced at $14,999, so it's not for everybody. It's a Snapdragon 615, so most the cheaper Snapdragon 615s are about 10,000 pesos. But this is $14,999. So I think yung nagpapamahal lang sa kanya talaga is obviously the battery, extra battery life. 5,000 milliamp hours is still unbeatable. If you're looking for the best battery, yung screen on time ko dito, I got about 8 hours and a half. Screenshots. There we go. Screen on time. Oh, yeah, may UC browser. Siya na-disable ko. Screen on time is 8 hours, 26 minutes. Yun yung pinaka medyo decent ko. But I still was managed to, yung screenshot niya was like 3%. And I got 8 hours, 26 minutes screen on time. But That was when I started the day around 92% battery. So pwede pang tumagal yan, around 9 hours screen on time. Which is pretty good, very, very good. Most phones these days are 3 to 4 hours screen on time. Let's see. I think nagbababahal sa kanya is NFC and fingerprint scanner and the extra battery life. So I guess that's it. I don't know, mukhang wala naman nagsasalita eh. So I guess nobody's really ano. Kaya pala smooth ng show, sabi ni Porto Zini. Yeah, it's we're using a different live stream right now. Okay, so that's it for the Lenovo Vibe P1. Let's talk about the P1M kasi mukhang mas, this is more in, the more interesting, mas unknown quantity sa dalawa. Here's the Lenovo Vibe P1 M. Screen share. There we go. Lenovo Vibe P1M is it's an entry-level device. Here it is. Here's what it looks like. Lenovo Vibe P1M, entry-level device. It's priced at 7,999. It's using a very interesting processor. That's the first time I've seen it. Quad-core MediaTek 6735P. 64-bit. This is a 64-bit processor kasi pag pumunta ka sa Antutu, it tells you that the benchmark is 64-bit. Yeah, switch to 32-bit. It says right there, switch to 32-bit. So that means it's a 64-bit. I guess all honestly, Antutu score niya is 21156, as you can see on the side here. It's got a 5-inch HD display. Android 5.1 Lollipop with Vibe UI. 8 megapixel front facing, 8 megapixel main camera, sorry. 8 megapixel main camera, 5 megapixel front, 2 gigs of RAM, which is okay, 16 gigs of storage with micro SD, 4,000 milliamp hour, non-removable battery. May case siya, so tagalin natin yung case. 4,000 milliamp hour, non-removable battery, pero fast charging. Hindi ko pa na-testing yung fast charging nito. Hindi ko pa nalulobat ito. Dual SIM LTE, and meron silang sinasabing splash-proof nano coating. So parang Motorola may splash-proof siya. Also comes with a free case and screen protector. Ito yung takip ng camera. Yung case niya is actually super flexible. I don't know if that's a thing or not, but it's super flexible yung case niya. Oh, nalaglag yung plastic. Okay. So the P1M is surprisingly smooth. It's a quad-core 64-bit MediaTek processor, as you can see here, makita nyo, medyo, it's pretty smooth eh. Wala, it doesn't have yung ano option to wala siyang option to what do you call this? To have a app drawer. So ang Lenovo Vibe UI niya is a little what do you call this? Limited. And hindi ko kilala to the reason why hindi ko kilala, there are some questionable things or some things na hindi ko ma-reason out why. But for example, if you pull down the ano notification shade, walang pinatakpan niya yung buong ano yung buong screen. Parang may ano siya eh, I don't know kung conscious decision yun, but nanawala yung buong screen sa notification shade. I don't know, maybe it's the processor, maybe that's a limitation na wala siyang ano, wala siyang transparency, but it seems like may transparency naman siya in some of these icons, for example, yan yung mga ano. Seems like may transparency naman siya. Look at this, yung folder, yung window folders or yung icon folders is still full screen din eh, which is weird. But everything else is pretty smooth. It's a quad-core 64-bit 1 gigahertz MediaTek. It runs games pretty cool, good eh. Here's let's run San Andreas. I'm pretty sure I nakapag-install and nakalogin na ako sa San Andreas dito. So it should be fine. See here. Surprisingly, there's a lot less comments pag ganitong live stream show. I don't know why. Maybe they're not interested in the topics. Ilan ba na nanonood? Hindi ko makita eh. Let's see how many people are watching. Here's Grand Theft Auto San Andreas on the 6.7 ano? Anong processor? 6735P processor. 1 gigahertz quad core. 1 gigahertz quad core, MediaTek. And it's pretty smooth. Diba? What do you think? How can a 1 gigahertz quad core 6735 processor run this game this smoothly? Come on. Guys, 1 gigahertz lang ito, quad core. Parang hindi nakakapaniwala eh. But it is a 64-bit processor, so maybe it's very optimized. So that only goes to show processor isn't everything, or at least one, ano, gigahertz or cores isn't everything. There you go. That's it. 4,000 mAh battery, which is really nice, in my opinion. It's only 7999. So, ang tanong dito is it gonna convince people to go with this kind of unknown processor, 6735P? The camera quality is so-so. Actually, let's just show you that. High-res po ba while playing? Of course, it's high-res. It's 720p. It doesn't bog down. Hindi siya bumababa yung quality or anything. So you can expect it. Here's some pictures from Here's some pictures from. This is the NO. This is what they know. Fit the screen. There we go. Right? Okay. Wait lang, ha? Dito na nga natin. Here's some pictures from the, what do you call this? This is from the Lenovo Vibe P1. Ang nakakatawa sa Vibe P1 is ang gulo, ang crazy nung ano niya, ang crazy nung, what do you call this? HDR niya, sobrang ang tingnan mo yung kulay nung HDR niya, sobrang nakaka-ano, parang alien eh. So ito yung pictures from the Cherry Mobile event. Here's Michael B, some people, Ernest Koo. Sobrang exaggerated yung colors ng HDR niya, which is a good thing and a bad thing. Some people will like, tingnan mo dito, here's an HDR na nasa loob ka ng kainan, na mini-stop at dito. Normally, any hirap nang mag-expose ito kasi sobrang bright sa labas and then may ano. Tingnan mo yung kulay ng ano. Sobrang kitang-kita mo dito sa HDR ng dinuguan. Hindi ganyan yung kulay ng dinuguan, guys. Mukha na siyang adobo sa sobrang HDR. Some more pictures here. I mean, wala lang, para makita nyo lang. Here's HDR, here's non-HDR. But the camera quality is pretty decent, in my opinion. Here's the low light. So, hindi nyo na makita. I mean, it's not gonna win any awards, in my opinion. Here's, dito sa low light siya, hindi na siya masyadong convincing, in my opinion. A lot of other brands can do better in this low light situation. Here's the front-facing camera. I would say not bad, but Lenovo has never been known for great cameras, unfortunately. But you know, thankfully it's still not that bad. And then we go to the P1M. Hindi ko masyadong mas konti yung pictures ko dito sa P1M. Let's screen share that. Go. Here's the P1M. There's a low light shot. It won't win any awards then. A lot of the other local brands can actually bitch slap this camera quality quite a bit. Tingnan mo to, wala na. Hindi mo na makita yung detalye ng ano ng picture dito. Parang ano, watercolor na to eh. Impressionist painting na itong ano eh. Sa low light. Here's the front-facing camera. There. So, respectable but won't win any awards at all. It's still not the quality you would be proud about. Most likely, okay, it'll be fine in decent light. But probably not the way, not the reason, not, hindi mo mapapagyabang na yung best camera phone or anything. Apparently, na-on ko yung flashlight, so let's turn that off. Paano yung flashlight, sorry. How do you turn the flashlight off? There. Okay. Okay. So, 11:38. I guess that's it for the Lenovo P1 and P1M. Does anybody still, no? Nobody is interested in the, ano, comes to buying, ano, comment system. So that's the P1 and P1M. I'm a bit of a fan of the both of them, P1 and P1M. Hindi ko alam kung which one I prefer. SRP, okay. The SRP is, let's see here. For the P1M, Lenovo Vibe P1M equals 7999. And the P1 P1 is 14. There we go. So it's only, let's turn the comments again. There we go. That's the SRP for both of them. I don't know which one I prefer more. I think if I'm going to be using them both, I'll be inclined to use the P1 kasi gusto ko yung NFC and fingerprint scanner, and I like the 5,000 mAh battery na talagang hirap. Malaking-malaki talaga yung baterya and mahirap talagang i-drain. And given that the P1M, which hindi ko pa masyado natitesting, with a 4,000 mAh battery na 1 GHz, hindi masyado, hindi sobra-sobra yung gigahertz niya. Hindi sobra-sobra yung, it's only quad-core, but it's 1 GHz quad-core, meaning matitipid mo yung baterya because hindi siya mataas yung CPU speed and cores. But it still runs pretty good in terms of gaming so far. Smooth naman yung interface. So like I said, it's surprising. Nakakagulat kasi quad-core nga na 1 GHz, diba? Very smooth interface for that processor. You got the 4,000 mAh battery. Unfortunately, wala nga masyadong extra features like fingerprint, NFC, or whatnot. Battery and ano lang talaga. And meron din siyang physical switch pala. May physical switch din siya to turn on the battery saving mode. Let's actually try that now. Baka kasi iba yung battery saving mode niya doon kesa doon sa P1. Hirap ako din. Yeah. See what the battery saving mode on the P1M looks like. Go. Oh, it's a different battery saving mode. Oh, wow. So meron siya. The battery saving mode on the P1M actually has apps. Pwede ka pa mag-music? What? Oh my god, that's cool. Pwede ko mag-face. Pero black and white. Ah, hindi black. Hindi naman. Yung may, yung ano lang. Yung home screen. And then you go back to the regular setting. Wow, they actually have multiple versions of the battery saving mode on two different phones. So I guess that's a real revelation. That's very interesting. Rainer Rizada, good evening BTS. Cherry Mobile just unveiled you for Cherry Prepaid and Action Camcorder nila. What's next, Cherry OS? I don't think. Pero maraming plans si Cherry Mobile. They have a lot of plans now for 2016. And Cherry Prepaid, that was one of the first few steps they'll take to enact this plan. All right, so that's it for the Lenovo P1 and P1M. Very interesting phones, both of them. I think gusto ko pang kalikutan si P1M. Medyo known quantity na si P1. It's got a large battery, decent if not extremely good, or I mean hindi naman award-winning si 6 Snapdragon 615. The 1 gigahertz quad core nitong P1M is still sobrang weird for me, and I want to experience, gusto kong matesting pa more. So let's move on to the Star Mobile Spectra. There we go. So here's the specs for the, oh, come on, my browser, there we go. Here's the specs for the Star Mobile Night Spectra. Here's the picture of it. May konting, may logo na Big Time Show, but here's what it is. It's another Snapdragon 615. It's also priced at 49.90. So this is kind of a quote-unquote competitor to the P1M. Yung battery nito is more modest in lieu of more Star Mobile-like specs. So we have a 5.5-inch 1920 by 1080 AMOLED scratch-resistant display, Android 5.1.1 Lollipop na most likely a ShanoGen Mod Edition. Light skin yung nilagay ko. 13 plus 2 megapixel rear camera. So, dual rear camera siya. There's a 2 megapixel ata sa kaliwa and 13 megapixel sa kanan niya. 8 megapixel front-facing camera, which is pretty decent. With LED flash. Take note, meron siyang front-facing camera flash. 3 gigs of RAM, which is nice. Very, very nice. 32 gigs of storage and 3,500 mAh non-removable battery. Dual SIM LTE, may digital TV receiver siya, although may kinakabit kang parang cable dun sa 3.5 mm headphone jack para magkaroon ka ng digital TV antenna. It's also USB OTG, hindi ko alam, most likely may SD install. Plus, and then free case, screen protector, digital TV antenna, and TV stand. I wouldn't say this is pretty straightforward. It's actually one of the kind of crazy phones out there. Let's go to the live, yung live blog natin sa kanya. The Star Mobile Night Spectra is essentially the first phone in the Philippines that launched with a dual camera on one side. And in this case, it's a dual rear camera. And as you can see, ando yung dual rear camera. The design, so if we compare it a little bit, so Star Mobile 9, here we go. Here's the Star Mobile Night Elite. Medyo malapit yung design niya with the Star Mobile Night Elite. But the difference between the Star Mobile Night Elite versus the Spectra is the Elite looks like an Sony Xperia Z3, Z2, whatever. With the, kind of a very tall design, kind of a 5-inch display, kind of medyo rounded edges and ganyan. It looks like a Xperia. But the Spectra, it's also a glass-on-glass design like an Xperia, but the sides look like an iPhone, which is nice. In my opinion, it looks nicer kasi napapagkamalan siyang bakal. It's actually, ano daw, metallic plastic ang design ng Star Mobile Lite Spectra. And I do like this AMOLED Full HD display. It's really, really nice. Of course, we're still talking about the Snapdragon 615, which I'm not a huge, huge fan of, but it does the job. It does the job. Well, no problem there. And you got that ShanoGen Mod Android Lollipop, which I like. It's not a bad skin at all. Meron akong ni-record na video for it. You know what? Let's experiment with the video. Tingnan natin kung mahigit kung hindi maglalag yung PC ko to death. Canon, no, that's not it. Star Mobile. Oh my God, I'm minimizing a lot of. Let's see if my PC won't lag to death. Here we go. It's got some videos here. Let's double click one of these. So, marami akong clips dito. Unfortunately, I can't show all of them. Here's one, 46 meg, 32 meg. Open the first one kasi yung pinakamalaki. There we go, 140 megs. And then it's a screen share ko. Come on. Let's see if it lags or doesn't. Yeah, Yeah, so what do you think of the dual camera? So the dual camera is, of course, another one of the features that some people will say is a gimmick, and I don't think I'll not agree. It's another feature that can blur the background or change the background color. I will tell you, okay, ganito yung background mo. It knows what you're taking a picture of in the background. Screen share this. This is completely yeah, VLC media player. There we here, yeah, here it is. There it is. I'm playing a video on my live stream. Yeah, fingerprint magnet siya. What do you think? First of all, nakikita niyo ba yung video? Pangalawa, is it not lagging? All right, there you go. So that's the Star Mobile Night Spectra. The screen, the capacitive buttons are on the screen now, and then there's the dual camera on the back. Glass on glass design, so super fingerprint magnet siya. But there's the back double camera. The flash is in the middle ng dalawa. Let's fast forward. The camera app has the refocus feature. Also, the camera app has the clear zoom, opti zoom, and chroma flash. And then yung makikita mo just sa menu ng camera niya may dual camera shot feature. Chroma flash, opti zoom, and stuff like that. I think it's a really nice phone, and they managed to make the Snapdragon 615 not lag so much. I think it's getting better. I think the Snapdragon 615 or the octa-cores na Qualcomm Snapdragon is getting better, quite a bit better. And yung ano niya, OptiZoom. Let's actually play another video after that. If you can, see this. There you go. Wabam! Sorry, maglalag. Nagano yan. Gagalaw kasi yung window. Go. And yung zoom effect niya, or actually ito yung blurring effect niya if you want to use the blurring effect. But anyway, that's it for that. Ayokong masira pa yung aking setup. So I'll close it and do that. Where's my comment box? Welcome to my comment box. Okay, the comments are okay. So yeah, that's the Star Mobile Night Spectra. You know what? Even if wala siya yung dual camera sa likod, I think this is a good phone. It's a little pricey at 14,999. For a lot of people, that's a little bit too much. But it's got 3 gigs of RAM, 3,500 milliamp hour battery, and the AMOLED display. I can live without the 2 megapixel, dual rear cam, in my opinion. It's got digital TV, although kailangan mo ng antenna. Another kind of a bummer, I guess. Let's bring back the comments here. I don't know. I don't what browser, browser. Yeah. Oh no. Browser is acting up. Anyway, that's the Star Mobile Lite Spectra 14,990. Quad-core snap, octa-core Snapdragon 615. Is it worth the price? Maybe. It's all about how you think the design looks like, and I think the design looks great. AMOLED display looks great. I don't know if I need the dual camera, but the 3 gigs of RAM is a welcome change, and 3,500 milliamp hour non-removable battery is okay. I would have wanted fast charging or wireless charging, but I don't think meron. So I guess that's it. I guess I'll wala na ko comment eh, so I don't know what's going on. I guess people aren't so enthused about the Star Mobile Night Spectra. Let's refresh the live stream right here. But. The stream is going okay though. Kamusta yung quality ng stream? Are you guys okay with this kind of thing? Problema, wala tayong host. Wala tayong guest, wala tayong host. Because mahirap yung streaming nito. The quality looks okay. It's not HD at all. I can't expect HD, but there you go. So the Spectra, here we go. Let's... Any cheaper alternatives to the Spectra? Of course. If I were somebody na nag-i-interest sa ano, there's always, sa processor pa lang, there's a lot of alternatives. Ipatatin yung camera para ano pa. Yeah, para bumalik na yung malinaw nating webcam. Tapos ano. Yeah. There we go. Let's move this here. There we go. Parang malaki. Ano pa kailangan kong gawin? I forgot. Kailangan ko i-adjust ng konti. There we go. Alternatives to the Star Mobile Night Spectra, you have the... In my opinion, still a good phone, except wala lang LTE for Star Smart. This is the Xiaomi Mi 4i. 1.7 GHz Snapdragon 615. One of the few phones that use the 1.7 GHz Snapdragon 615. They started using 1.5 GHz instead of 1.7 for overheating reasons. I don't know. Paano namatay yung Mi 4i ko? Baka naloka. I use this a lot. This is very good for VR, watching VR. For some reason, maganda yung gyroscope niya. The display is really, really nice. I have to give it to Xiaomi. The Concord Glass. This is actually a Corning Concord Glass phone. I don't know kung marami pang gumagawa ng Corning Concord Glass. It's very interesting technology where naka-band, naka-ano, it's like OGS, I guess. The protective screen, the actual protective screen is actually bonded to the touch and LCD layer, which is crazy. Mi 4i is nice. I think wala na talaga ano. It's 16 gigs non-expandable, non-upgradable, non-removable battery and everything. So talaga ano. But it's super nice looking. It's a really, really nice looking phone. Alternatives. The Asus Zenfone Selfie is 12,000 pesos. 13 megapixel camera sa likod, 13 megapixel camera sa harap. With a dual tone flash, removable battery, expandable storage, lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of Asus bloatware. Lots and bloatware for days. But still, not a bad phone. In my opinion, though, if you have 15,000 pesos, yun ang maraming alternatives, the 15,000 peso range. You can get the Moto X second gen. You can get if you're not looking for entirely brand new, you can look for a LG G3. You can look for mga Galaxy S5 from last year, mga nasa 15 to something yun. The Zook Z1, although hindi ko pa nakakalikod si Zook Z1. There's a lot of sobrang daming alternatives. Ako, I would go for the Moto X second gen or Zenfone 2 original. The Zenfone 2 original with 32GB or 64GB of storage. With the Intel Atom Z3780 processor, that thing is still amazing performance, even with all that bloatware. Bloatware for days. Bloatware for days, guys. Asus. Alam mo nyo, nung nagsimula, nung lumabas yung Zenfone 2 ng Asus, it had a decent amount of bloatware, pero hindi pa sila all-in. No, Moto G is under 10K. Moto X is around 15, pababa. Asus was, yung bagong Zenfone 2, konti pa lang yung bloatware niya. Hindi pa sila madalas mag-update. Ngayon yung bloatware ng Zenfone is nadagdagan ata ng 15 bloatware si Zenfone eh, over the course of the simula ng Zenfone 2 papunta ng November today. Dami na nilang dinagdag. Hindi ba dapat binabawasan mo eh? Grabe si Asus. Nasa may 15K si Moto X second gen. Moto G is around 10K. Let's see. Okay, let's look at the price. Motorola. If we can wait, there's the Moto X play for in India. Hopefully, the Matis Filipinas. Moto G 2014 is 8499. Yeah, and Moto X is. Dapat pala binago. Hindi ko pala na-update to. It should say may price drop si Moto X second gen at 14999. There's a lot of last year's flagships for 15K. You can buy a Nexus 6 gray market for around 17. You can buy a you can buy LG G4 for 19 or 18 kung single SIM. Maybe the only time Asus doesn't send you bloatware is if they create the next Nexus device. Ah, yeah. Oh, man. Anyway, sobrang dami bloatware si Asus. I don't understand why. Well, bumabawi sila, binabawi nila yung pera nila na in-invest. Meron na talaga. It's... What? Ano to? Ah, Adobo Chronicles. Sino naniwala dito? Si Brandon Nobino niwala sa Adobo Chronicles. Yeah, I guess that's it. Ano ba topics natin na hindi na pag-usapan? Lenovo Vibe S1, Lenovo Vibe P1, P1M, Star Mobile Spectra. Oh yeah, so Star Mobile, in Star Mobile news, nagkaroon ng bagong COO si Star Mobile. His name is Jerry Manos. He used to work for Nokia and Apple here in Asia. He's now a chief operating officer for Star Mobile. That position used to be non-existent for the company. So ngayon may bago silang position for the company called chief operating officer, which means there will be changes in their organizational structure. There's a lot of positions na nag-iiba yung pangalan sa kanila. I don't know, I mean, it's not gonna affect yung, any of the brands, but so far, ano lang. That's just a thing. So yeah, I guess that's it. Maaga tayo na topic. I don't know why. I guess walang masyadong interesado sa mga produkto na topics natin. I mean, the Cherry Mobile is interesting, but you can't really play around with it. We should also... Let's talk about this. I guess. Star Mobile Play Spark. Let's open it. The specs here. Let's talk about the specs here. This is actually a new unit from Star Mobile. Tinanggal ko lang sa topics because I thought we don't have enough time. Let's get that in focus. Come on. Yeah, here it is. Here's the Star Mobile that Daniel Subron is referring to. Where's my autofocus? That's why wala tayong, yeah, there we go. Android 4.4 KitKat, dual SIM 3G. Let's get that manual focus on that. Yeah. Spreadtrum 7731G. That's a quad core processor, 1.3. 4 inch TFT wide VGA display. That's 800 by 480. 4 gigs of ROM, 512 MB RAM. 32 gig micro SD expansion, 2 megapixel camera, VGA front. Pa ba to? 1,500 milliamp hour battery. And screen protector, micro USB battery, headset, quick start card, warranty card. Mukhang wala siyang ano, mukhang wala siyang free case. But let's open it. Tingnan natin yung laman. I don't think kailangan natin buksan to. The processor, the Spreadtrum 7731 can handle Clash of Clans fine. It is. Star Mobile. Let's get the focus. Marami siyang kulay, pero I guess itim yun ako natin. Star Mobile. 4-inch 800 by 480 display. You know what? A few years ago, maganda na yung spec. Well, maganda pa rin naman yung specs ito. This is, I don't know what the price is though. Binigay lang, inabot lang sa amin ito. Star Mobile Play Spark. Let's Google the price for this guy. 1,990. So 2,000 pesos. I think this is what they were saying was the cheapest dual quad-core Android phone. 1,999. Spreadtrum 7731G, which runs 2D games fine, but don't expect it to play 3D games. So let's refresh this browser and see if we can get it on. Oh, I'm dropping frames. I'm dropping internet. Refresh. Star Mobile. Go. Oh, crap. Let's see if this works. There we go. No, that's Logitech. What? I got it data. There we go. here's the Star Mobile Play Spark specs. Android OS, quad-core power, handy and compact, Star Mobile App Store, Star Mobile Care app. 1,990. It looks like that. Fake yung bezels niya kasi mas malaking bezels niya dito sa totoong unit. Here's the specs. Yan. 1500, 7731G. Micro SD. Maganda siguro kung mayroong mga free micro SD na yung ganito, no? Kasi medyo nakakabitin kung wala siyang SD. Micro SD at all. But there it is. There's the, that's the Star Mobile Night Spark, Play Spark. Ryan Santos, sir, ba't yung Flare 4 ko, 12 gigs lang, yung internal, pwede ko ipa- No. Ganun talaga yun. Most phones will take up about 3 to 4 gigs of storage. Yung 16 gigs niya. Some part of it will be any phone with, for example, 4 gigs yung ROM mo. Kakainin niya yung mga 2 to 3 gigs because the system will take up no. Parang for example, PC mo, you have a 1 terabyte hard drive or let's say 500 gig hard drive. 10 gigs on kakainin ng Windows, pretty much. Which essentially, Android is just hiding the fact na may file siya doon sa Android mo. So, yung Flare 4 mo has 16 gigs. Actually, 16 gigs translates to about 15.2 gigs ata. In actual gigabytes. And a little bit of that is eaten by the system because it needs file, ano, wala siyang dedicated file storage for its system files. So it uses the file storage ng internal mo, naka-partition yan. Naka-partition to save that partition inaccessible partition. So, ang lilitaw na lang sa'yo is like 11.8 gigs or 12 gigs out of the 16. Ginagamit talaga ang system. You don't expect na you can get all the 16. And it's a small amount of amount of storage to eat out of. Install naman ng micro SD, okay ka na yan. It's just 3 gigs, it's fine. I guess that's it. Are we done? Surprisingly, let's see. I want to see what the live stream looks like. YouTube.com/ Live. Huwag mo pa warranty, Mr. Ryan Santos. Oh, mali. What? Wrong link. Extra. There we go. Every time I look at the stream, it actually is a pretty decent looking stream. Medyo decent quality and everything. But I guess that's it for now. So that's it for the show, guys. I'm Alex from thetechnoclass.com. I guess that's it for the show. Oh, nag-lag yung aking PC. We've talked about the, you know, the Lenovo Vibe P1 with the fingerprints. Come on, fingerprint. There we go. Ah, hindi pa rin kumagat. There you go. Kailangan kasi baliktad yung bagay ng thumb ko, dapat ganun yung finger. The Vibe P1 I like. It's a lot, it's not for everybody. Large alam niyo mga Pilipino, ayaw nilang magbayad pero gusto nilang malaking baterya. So these kinds of products, the Lenovo Vibe P1 with the 15,000 peso price point, 14,999. Sasabi, ang mahal naman niya, sasabi nila. And then pag nakita nila yung mga Flare 4, Flare S4, sabi nila, ah, mahal, ba't ang liit ng baterya, 2,000 something something lang. That's because you have to pay for the battery, guys. You have to, ano. But a lot, there will be people out there that says, ah, gusto ko 4,000 pesos lang, but 5,000 milliamp hour battery. There are those kinds of people, unfortunately. But if you really, you know, for road warriors na, ako nagamit ko na to as a road warrior myself. My personal choice is normally my power bank or my spare battery, which I already do on my Galaxy S5 right here. Makita nyo, may AMOLED display and may keyboard ako for productivity. I have spare batteries for these. I have power banks, but madaling malobat ito. But for example, there are events where hindi ka pwede magdala ng spare battery, hindi ka pwede magdala ng power bank. Although spare battery madali lang, but for example, naka-formal ka, naka-coat and tie ka and everything, hindi ka makapagdala ng wala kang bag. Wala kang pagbabaunan. So this kind of device with 5,000 milliamp hour battery, hanggang ngayon di pa nauubos yung baterya. Magto 2 days na to over over 2 days, might reach 3 days kasi hindi masyadong heavy use today, but that kind of device is a godsend for certain people. It's not for every single person out there, but these kinds of devices are a godsend for certain people. Now I wanna say something. This thing is such an interesting combination of processor, battery, and whatnot, the P1M. I really gusto ko pang kalikutin tong P1M with the 1 GHz quad-core 64-bit processor with a 21K AnTuTu score. Pretty smooth UI, and gaming is pretty smooth as well. Kind of super crazy phone here. With 4,000 mAh battery, let's find out kung gaano katagal yung battery niya with the combination of the processor. So we'll find out. But yeah, that's it. I guess that's it for the show. Let's see kung ano yung pinaka least interesting device today. It's either the S1 or the Spectra. I guess I would say the S1 is the least interesting out of all the topics today. The Spectra is interesting. It's a nice design AMOLED display. Not so much the dual rear camera for me, but I like the design. I like that it looks so nice. Fingerprint magnet though. P1 is of course large battery. P1M is crazy processor thing. So yeah, I guess that's it. Ryan Santos, kakapasok niya lang daw sa live stream. Hey, thanks po. Yeah, you're welcome. I guess that's it for the show, guys. I'm Alex from thetechnoclass.com. That has been your big time show for November 14, 2015. Let me know kung okay yung ganitong stream or not. It's kind of an interesting, ano. I like the technology na gamit natin. Unfortunately, hindi ako pwede mag-patch ng ibang host if I wanted to. Problema kasi ng kabilang stream is the comment system. But anyway, we'll figure it out. Alex from thetechnoclass.com here. Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you guys next week. Pwede ko na ba sabihin? I guess the post na sa ibang ano, somebody already leaked this information. The LG V10. The LG V10 is launching in the Philippines soon, in about a week or so. We'll live stream it as a live stream. We'll live vlog it as well, katulad ng live vlog ng ibang brands. I don't know if a lot of people will be, you know, what. Keeping track of the live blog because medyo kilala naman yung specs and everything. But ang gusto ko sa live blog is wala na akong trabaho pagdating ko sa bahay. So malaki, it helps me. So I don't care kung if people are, ano, are in, ano ba, binabantayan yung live blog or not. So, iba live blog ko yun para meron na akong post pagdating ko sa bahay. But yeah, LG V10, very interesting. It's not for everybody. Of course, mamahalin siya na konti. I like its video capabilities, and I wish I had a phone that has good video capabilities more than I'm still using the Lumia 1020, and basura yung OS nun, basura mode, that basura.com. I know people are gonna hate me for hating the Windows one, but come on, basurang OS. All right, so I guess that's it for the show. Thank you for watching, Sir Dial Daniel, Kyle Daniel Subron, Ryan Santos, lahat na Rainer Rizada, sino pa ba nandyan? Porto Sili, Aaron Ocampo, Milo, and Antonio Arenas, I think, is in there. Brethren Pablo, thanks for watching. Let me know if you like this kind of stuff, or maybe we'll go back to the Hangouts mode. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys next time.